Hey everybody, and welcome back to another episode of 7-Minute AE Tutorials, where you learn AE tips, tricks, and shortcuts in less than 7 minutes. No BS, just AE. In this episode, I'll show you how to sequence layers in order to create transitions and backgrounds. I'll go over the basics of how to set it up so you can experiment, try some cool things out, and add one more tool to your motion design belt. Okay, so let's start a new composition. I'm going to go through some of these shortcuts. I think that the repetition will really help you out in learning how to incorporate shortcuts into your projects. So Control N, this creates a new composition. And we'll just leave this at Comp 1, hit OK. Now we want to create a background, so Control Y. I'm going to use shape layers in order to animate this. So let's right click anywhere down in here and do new shape layer. So let's go to add rectangle. Let's add a fill. Make this fill something like an orange. Open up this rectangle path here and we're going to make the size 1080 high. I'm going to use 10 of these rectangles going from left to right in this example. What we'll do is we'll make this 1920 and we'll divide it by 10, which is 192. If you hit Y, bring up your pan behind tool. If you grab that and start to drag it and then hold down the control button, it will snap right here. So you can actually snap it anywhere you want. You can see this line comes up. So let's put it in the far left corner. Let's hit P to bring up our position and we want to go all the way to 0. Okay, so what we want to do basically is we want to line up 10 of these so they go all the way from left to right. Before I do that, I want to animate this shape layer. So that way we don't have to keep repeating the animation and copying keyframes. So what we want to do is we want to make sure that we're on the transform properties of the shape layer and not the rectangle path. We want to leave this at 192 by 1080. So let's just close that up. And we're going to focus on the transform properties of the shape layer itself. So let's hit the stopwatch for scale. Hold down shift and page down to move up 10 frames. So let's unlink that so that way we can affect the X and Y values independently. Let's hit another keyframe and this will be our ending keyframe. If you hit I, it goes back to the very beginning of your layer. And then let's change our Y size to 0, just like that. Okay, so let's take the second keyframe and hit Shift F9 to give us an easy in. We'll open up our graph editor. And now let's just pull this over like that. So that way we have that kind of a shape there. So what we need to do now is we need to fill up this whole screen with these rectangles. And remember, we want 10 of these. So let's just hit Control D to duplicate this layer. Go 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Remember now, our position here is at 0. And these rectangles are 192 pixels wide. So we need to increase the position by 192 for each shape layer. Let's highlight all of these. Hit P for position. 192 for shape layer 2. Shape layer 3, we can do 192 times 2. 192 times 3. 192 times 4, 192 times 5, 192 times 6, 192 times 7, 192 times 8, and 192 times 9. I'm going to go back to the beginning of all of these layers and hit Alt right bracket. So that way we have a single frame here. This next step is very important. If you want this to animate from left to right, you have to select your shape layers from bottom to top. If you select it from top to bottom, it will go from right to left. Shape layer 1, hold down the shift button and go to shape layer 10. Then let's go to animation, keyframe assistant, sequence layers. What this is going to do is it's going to put each one of these layers end to end. We'll just go with the default setting and hit OK. Now if we hit U, we see our keyframes are still there. What we want to do is we want to go to the very end here at 10 seconds and hit Alt right bracket. And that brings everything over. Now let's hit 0. And so we have something kind of like that. Now there's some other cool things that we can do with this. Say for example, we wanted them all to end at the same time. Drag these over, or one other thing you can do, if you highlight this keyframe here, hit Control X, Control V. Control X, Control V. And what this is doing, this is cutting and pasting. And as long as you're on the right layer, it will cut whatever keyframe you have and paste it where your playhead is. So Control X, Control V. Control X, Control V, and do it one more time. So like if you highlight all of your keyframes here, and if you hold down the Alt key and pull this over, it will drag them all or it'll scrunch them all together or spread them all out while keeping the same relative distance between each keyframe. So see, we have something with a little bit different kind of movement here. It's a little bit slower. Again, if you hold down the Alt key and come left, it will keep the same relative distance. Let's highlight all of these, hit Control Shift C to pre-compose. So now we have our pre-comp of that animation. Control D to duplicate the pre-comp one. And now let's add a fill to make it red. If you hit R to pull up the rotation, flip that around to 180, and now let's offset this. So you can have something kind of like that. It's kind of cool. If you want to go the other direction, you can right click on this pre-comp and go to transform, flip horizontal. So now the top pre-comp is coming in the opposite direction. Do the same thing for this. If you want that to reverse that, flip horizontal. One of the things I think is pretty cool, let's get rid of this pre-comp here. If I put some text in here, and let's put this underneath pre-comp one, so that way it's behind it. But now let's take these two layers and Control D to duplicate them. And what we're going to do is we're going to move this text layer to position two, make this track mat alpha. Let's change this color of this to say black. And so I'll see you have this. Sequencing layers is a good way to transition on a background or create a transition between scenes. I'll go over more complex layer sequencing in future episodes, but this should be good enough to get you experimenting with this new trick. I hope this helped you out. Please subscribe, like, share, and comment. Let me know in the comments below if there's anything you'd like to see and if this episode was helpful. Thanks, everybody. See you next time.